well aware that flies can be dangerous, even lethal, but mostly just annoying. It's time to swat this one down. He's resurfaced. Did you hear about the hoax at DC General Hospital? The hostage situation that wasn't?
I caught it on the news. But what does that have to do with Wu Jing?
I have it on good authority that he's enlisted the help of another former Blacklister, the troll farmer. The hospital hoax has all the hallmarks. Doctored media, online social channels buzzing, a very real law enforcement response.
But didn't the troll farmer work alongside you all those years ago? Do you really think he turned?
If Wu Jing convinced him that his time in federal prison was my doing, I'd imagine he'd have a rather large axe to grind, and deservedly so. Look into the hoax. I suspect it'll lead you to the troll farmer, and he'll lead us to that buzzing fly, Wu Jing.
Okay, we will. On one condition. Get a new phone.
It was Cooper who found Reddington. Apparently he's living in a bathhouse. Anyway, give us the name of another Blacklister, Bo Chang.
Wait a minute. You mean the troll farmer?
I hate to be the new girl, but who's this troll farmer?
Well, Bo Chang, a.k.a. the troll farmer, helped Reddington and Keen obscure their location a few years ago when they were on the run.
He specializes in highly coordinated disinformation campaigns. He and his team use social media, doctored photos, first-person accounts to create the illusion of a crisis unfolding. These events are so convincing, they generate a very real media and law enforcement response.
Interesting. But to what end?
Well, the events he creates are just distractions. They're strategically designed so that he can safely commit another crime during the chaos. We arrested him back then. He served some time, but got out recently on good behavior. Now, Reddington believes that he's in town working with Wu Jing as revenge for being taken by the FBI.
The DC General Hospital hoax.
Yeah, how did you know?
It was trending on Rambler for hours yesterday. I was watching it unfold live. Didn't you see it?
I don't ramble. Is that even the right verb?
It's not my thing.
Chang must be good. There are authentic-looking photos, first-hand accounts, people claiming there was an active shooter, a nurse taken hostage. I watched one live feed of a woman supposedly posting from a utility closet. She was hiding, afraid to take a breath or even move an inch because the gunman was just outside. She even had audio. It was quite convincing.
Let's start by reviewing all the fake social media posts. You should take the lead on this, Sia. You seem to have a knack for it.
I'm embarrassed to say I'm well-versed in Rambler. There'll be no stone unturned.
I apologize for my absence this morning. Any updates on the case?
We've reviewed all of the original social media posts that started the Rambler storm. Many of them contain the same photo of the gunman with a hostage.
Now, we discovered that the gunman and the hostage in the photo were real, but from a separate incident in 2013 at a medical facility in Ohio. The photo was a deep fake.
Anything in the images metadata that gets us closer to Wu Jing?
Unfortunately, no. We also looked into the 14 accounts that started everything. Half the accounts belong to real employees of the hospital. Chang hacked them. The others were fake, with IP addresses all over the world.
We're focusing on the hoax, but what was he trying to bury underneath it?
We went down that path, too. Now, based